Hey everybody, welcome to today's video. If you are new here, I'm Jamie B. Thanks for stopping by. So for today's video, I am just going to be doing a quick and easy anti-haul. I try to get a couple in a year. I don't do them monthly just because I feel like that's overwhelming of negativity or anti-whatever, but I do like to group them and just select them as I go and make a whole video for you guys. So if you're excited or curious as to what I am not buying and why, then go ahead and hit that subscribe button at the bottom of this video and we will get right into it. All right, so I am just pulling up my Instagram because that is how I do this. If you are new here, I go to Trend Mood's Instagram page. If you don't know her, it's Trend Mood One on Instagram. She has all of the up-to-date new launches and beauty and skincare and all that jazz. So I do like to just reference her page just to make it easier instead of me going, you know, to Ulta, to Sephora, what's coming out. I just like to go to her page and just kind of scroll down and save what I like, what I don't like, and all of that. So if you do not follow her, again, it is TrendMood1 on Instagram. Okay, so the first thing that is up is the new ColourPop and Raw Beauty Christie collab. It is at Forest Site, I believe is the whole collection. I'm not really certain. It just says Raw Beauty Christie x ColourPop. And then the palette says at Forest Site. And then the lip glosses say Luxe Gloss. So I'm not really sure what the actual collab is called, but this is what it looks like. It's just a lot of natural like colors, pinks, browns, auburns, blues, like a navy blue, a dark green, and golds. I've just kind of, I feel like, strayed away from ColourPop. I think it was last year where they were like launching. They still do launch very fast, but it's not as bad as it was. Like, it was like every couple of days, ColourPop had something new coming out. They are still pretty quick with launches. And I just kind of feel like, it just turned me away from it, honestly. There's no negativity or like scandal there. I just don't care for the company very much anymore. I just feel like they wanted quantity over quality, and it wasn't really about kind of what we wanted or what we liked. They just want to pump stuff out, and eventually they're gonna run into a wall because they've done everything and anything, and then that's it for ColourPop. Like, they're just gonna be gone. So I will not be getting that collection. Okay, so sorry, I had to put some lip gloss on. My lips were looking crusty. Okay, so the next thing that I have here is the Fenty Beauty, I believe it's called the Diamond Balm. It is a new highlighter coming out for their collection in 2020 for the holidays. The reason that I don't want it is because in the description on Fenty's website or Instagram, it says it's a jelly-like product to sparkle, jelly to sparkle. Yeah, so it says here in our jelly to sparkle formula, it looks like it's gonna be a nice highlighter. It doesn't look like it's gonna be too glittery, but I don't like the jelly formula in anything. I know that Stila had it, I didn't like it there, like the jelly putty. I know that Fursali, whatever it is, had it and I didn't like that. Becca Cosmetics had one and I didn't like that. So I just kind of steer away from the jelly formula, and sparkle kind of makes me think glitter. So I've just opted to not get that one. If you guys get it and you love it and it's not what I think it is, then comment it down below so I can go get it too if it's amazing. But if it's not, I don't want any parts of it. Okay, so the next one is actually another holiday collection. I don't know if I showed you. I did show you guys if anyone. Okay, so the next one is another holiday collection. It is the Kylie Cosmetics holiday collection. Usually I do not get a lot of holiday collections from anybody, but this one is going to be a huge no for me just because it's all mini. And if you're not new here, you know how I feel about mini. I just don't like them. I just don't care to spend my money on mini sizes. I feel like I could just get a deluxe sample of something and that would be nice, but I'm just not going to spend that kind of money on mini items. I just don't like them. I don't like them in my collection, so I avoid them like the plague. So the next eyeshadow palette is going to be the Sugar Cookies palette from Beauty Bakery. I don't have any issues with this company. I think that they do usually a very fantastic job at launches, at products. I just don't like the colors that are in this one. I don't see myself going to them or to just use one palette to create a color from it. If anything, it would be like that blue and that orange and maybe a little bit of that shimmery champagne color, but that's about it. So I would not be buying that one just because I don't feel like I'll use it enough. I do think it's a cute idea, but I just feel like it should have been like gingerbread or something. I don't see why it's sugar cookie. It's blue. I don't know. So the next item is another eyeshadow palette for the win. It's actually Jeffree Star Cosmetics Blood Money collection. I am not going to be purchasing anything from it. All scandals aside, seriously, I just don't like that it's all green. I know it has like some pukey browns in it, and I'm just not interested in that either, but I just feel like he's kind of like taking, like he did, you know, the red palette and then a blue palette and it was like, yes. And now it's like, okay, you're kind of dragging us at this point. Like it's tired. Maybe something new. I just feel like, again, there are ColourPop palettes that I can buy or I do have that would make this up. But for me, I'm just gonna show you guys again. I don't know if I did. It's just too, it reminds me of throw up. I'm not gonna lie to you. It just reminds me of throw up. The lipsticks I'll never use and they're mini and I hate mini. The highlighters, I heard that those were very shimmery highlighters. They're not like his normal highlighters. The Extreme Frost or whatever they're called. I've never tried his eyeliner, so I don't know anything about that. I don't know if that's a new item, but I just don't really use pencil liner. So to me, it just wouldn't really work out. I also don't like the fact that it's called Blood Money. I don't know why that bothers me. Just in like the time that we are right now with everything going on and like, I don't know. I just don't like it. I don't like it. Please don't come for me. I'm just not buying it. The palette looks like vomit. So moving on. So the next thing is actually skincare. It's the Dose of Colors, skincare line. They just revealed it, I believe, recently. It's coming with like a cleanser. Looks like a daily moisturizer. Cold pressed booster. I'm just very picky about my skincare. So I recently started buying Wishful Skin, which is Huda's line. And I was kind of iffy about that, but it actually turned out really good. I absolutely love the Clean Genie. My daughters use it, I use it. It gets everything off and it doesn't irritate our skin because we have very dry, sensitive skin. So I'm just very picky about my skincare. And honestly, I haven't bought anything Dose of Color in like forever. Like, I don't know where they've been. Maybe I'm just missing them, but I don't know where they've been. This is not a very anti-haul, but I'm excited for this. I don't know if you guys have seen this. However, James Charles is apparently doing his own makeup line. This is not anti. I will be buying this. I am kind of excited. I'm just hoping, because from the looks, it says another fun fact, I'm wearing products from my makeup line in the Vogue photos. So the only thing I'm worried is that it's going to be another kind of rainbowy palette, which we already kind of have from him and Morphe. So if it is that, I probably will not buy it. But this is not part of the anti haul. I'm just really excited about that. I saw that the other day. And then the Patrick Ta, it's another holiday item. The Major Glow, it's the new Major Glow Face Glow. She Gives Me Life, limited edition. It's a jelly, like a highlighter jelly, just like Kylie and Kendall had collabed and made for Kylie's brand. I didn't like that. I'm not gonna like this. I don't like that sticky like consistency. It's just not something, I don't know what you do with it. I don't know why you would put like that on your face. I feel like it would be very heavy. I know that that jelly stuff I put on my eyes was awful. It was sticky. I just wasn't a fan. So I'm not gonna be getting that one either. So another item, I know it's kind of older because of Halloween, but I decided not to buy it. It was the Melt Cosmetics like Beetlejuice collection. I like the idea. I think it's fun. It's festive. But I'm not gonna wear any of those colors. Again, it's that green and just colors that I'm not, and then you got red, and I have a million and one red lipsticks, but like the yellowy green, they're kind of hard to wear. I will put them in sometimes in my makeup looks, just trying to like throw them in there, but I really just don't go to those pukey green colors. I don't know who does, I don't. If you do, that's your thing, but I just don't. And then the last item also is not super new. It came out, think it was like a couple weeks ago or just recently. It looks like it launched on, I don't know, it doesn't tell me, but it is a holiday collection as well. It's limited edition. It is the Natasha Denona palette, the new one, and I think it's called the Trio Chrome eyeshadow palette. Yeah, so I just, it's $129, and I feel like for $129 they could have done maybe a little bit more to like grab your attention. The only three that I'm really interested in are the three that go down in the middle, because they are like a trio chrome, like you get three different colors, and I'll go ahead and I will show you that on their hand here. So that's pretty cool, but the rest of them just kind of seem bleh. And I feel like if I go bleh to a palette for $129, count me out. Check, I'm out. Thank you. Take care. So again, if you like it, if you got it, comment and tell me. But for me, it's gonna be a no because I'm not paying $129 for three eyeshadows that I might like. So that is it currently for my Auntie haul. There are a lot of things on here I am going to be purchasing, or I have purchased and they're on their way. But other than that, it wasn't a lot of things. There are like a lot of things on her page that I just don't buy because I don't buy from that company, or I don't know them, or they're an indie brand or something like that. But those are the specific like outright things that I ain't buying and the reasons why. So as always, like there's no hate, there's no shade towards these companies, towards the creators. It's just things that in my opinion are not worth me purchasing. And as always, if you want to buy them, you can buy them. I am not stopping you. I have no control over you or your bank account. So those are the reasons why I am not buying them. If you are buying any of those or you have bought them, tell me down below why you're buying it. Do you love it? If you have it already, should I buy it? Like, am I being too quick to judge? Let me know. And as always, guys, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. It does help me. And I will see you on the next one. Bye.